Are you going through a silent treatment from your guy? Well, in this video, I will share with you 5 reasons why his silence is a decision and how to handle it. Hello, my name is Greta Bereshide. I'm dating and relationship coach for women. For the awesome high value women secrets, subscribe to my channel and click the bell to be notified when I upload new videos every Wednesday and Sunday. And just before I share with you those 5 reasons, don't forget to take my self-awareness test to find out are you a woman of high value or low value, which I will drop down in the video description box below. And if you like any of my merch, Chase Goals and Non-Drama, you can get this in my YouTube store. So if you're in a place where you are going through a silence treatment from him, and you have no idea why, you're feeling insecure, you're feeling nervous, you don't know why he's doing it, you don't know what's going on, you don't know will he be back, you don't know is this a punishment, you don't know is this a boundary, you don't know is he not interested and is ghosting you, or what is happening, well then this video is of course for you. As in this video, I will break down for you, giving you 5 reasons why his silence is a decision, why is this happening, and how to handle it. In no particular manner, the reason number 1. So, for example, if a guy broke up with you, and you don't know does he still have feelings for you or not, I would really recommend you to check out my video, What is a Woman of High Value? And if you will recognize your high value behaviors in that video, then it's very likely that even though the breakup happened, he still had very strong feelings for you. If, however, you were behaving very low value, so check out my video, What is a Woman of Low Value here, then very likely he broke up with you because he lost attraction for you. Now, when a guy breaks up with a girl and he feels like he still has very strong feelings for her, in the beginning he might actually try to convince himself that he's gonna be over her like in a couple days or a couple weeks, because if he's very cool, very likely he will try to convince himself that it's nothing and he can get another girl just like that. But the reality is, if he had very strong feelings for you, you guys are going through a breakup, it's not as easy just like that to get over a person. A lot of times it can even take years and years and years. So because men are so logical, this is what they usually do. They give themselves a time frame. So for example, if let's say 2 weeks went by and you still realize that he has strong feelings for you, but he is in his mind knows that it's not the right thing to do to come after you, he might give himself a time frame to see will he still have feelings for you after that time frame. If he still has feelings for you after that time frame, this is when he decides to come after you and pursue you again. I remember I was talking to this guy and he had very strong feelings for this girl and he actually broke up with her and she was somewhat on a high value side. And in my mind, when he told me the relationship, I was like, there is no way he's gonna get over her just like that. There is no way. And in the beginning, he was acting very, very cool. And then a couple weeks later, he said, Greta, I can't forget her. I still think about her. He said, I'm gonna give myself a time frame of 2 months. If after 2 months, I'm still not over her, then I will get in touch with her and see what happens. Of course, 2 months after, he had the feelings for her just as strong as before, if not even stronger. That is exactly when we both reconciled again. So as a lady, how do you handle it? You leave him to it. You do not go after him. You do not chase him. You do not pursue him. You leave him to it. Give him all the space that he needs. And you let him come to you if he decides to do so. Of course, not every single guy will have a time frame for something like that. But if he does a time frame, I want you to understand that the time frame is different from each guy. Some guy's time frame might even be a year. Another guy's time frame might be a couple weeks. The other guy's time frame might be 2 months. Ladies, if you want to know how to get your ex back, have an awesome video for sale, which I will drop in the video description box below. Number two, where the silence is a decision. When a guy sets in a boundary, a lot of guys punish girls with a silent treatment. So for example, if you have been rude, or perhaps he didn't like something about you, or maybe you've been disrespectful, or something else has happened, or maybe you have been disrespectful, or he didn't like the way you behaved, he might punish you with the silent treatment. What he will do, he will go cold on you, will start to ignore you for specific period of time. And usually guys set it in their mind. So he might sit in a silent treatment for a week or a silent treatment for 2 weeks. Some guys even sit in a silent treatment for as long as a month. A different guy, a different time frame. Obviously, this type of punishment, it's a total nonsense. With many women, it does work and it actually makes women to submit after. Many other women, it does not work, and what we do, we just break up with the guy before the silent treatment is over. Because it doesn't work, it's immature, and at the end of the day, it creates resentment rather than a boundary anyway. So how do you handle it? I would say there are a couple of ways to handle this, and I would recommend you to choose the way that you feel like is the most aligned with you. So one of the ways, if, for example, you guys really had a very, very nasty fight and he's giving you a silent treatment, I personally would recommend to let it go and let him cool down and come to you, right? Even if it's a week or longer than that. If your argument was extremely nasty, and abuse it, because you will both need time to cool down before you can face each other. If he's giving you a silent treatment because you have said something disrespectful and he is pushing it for as long as a week or a couple of weeks, well then, when he does get in touch, I personally would send him a message that, let's say, it's not working for me. So that way you're setting in a boundary that your type of punishment will not get you to submit or chase or pursue you. That way you're setting in a boundary saying that I don't accept these type of punishments in a relationship, therefore I'm stepping out of it. If on the other hand you feel like you cannot break up with him, or you want to give it a second chance and you're hoping that he's not gonna do the silent punishment again, when a guy doesn't contact you for a week or 2 weeks, moaning or complaining or voicing your opinion usually does not work, because you're basically showing that it has really affected you and you're still communicating with him. So he's just gonna be great. My silent punishment really worked because she's showing how upset she got over it. However, if you're in a place where you don't feel strong enough to break up with a guy when he gave you a week or 2 weeks of silent punishment, then he does eventually get in touch with you, I would just recommend you not to say anything at all. Like, you just been focused on your life and just totally ignore his tantrum, his silent punishment, as it was not important. You ignore something and you make it not important. A lot of times people don't do the same stuff again because you're not reacting towards it. Saying that when it comes to silent punishments, usually guys do it again, they make it much longer. If you're not strong enough to break up with him or to set in a breakup boundary, maybe ignore it the first time and then build up your confidence. So if it happens the second time, you will feel confident and strong enough to do the right thing. Number three, why his silence is a decision. Well, this is very, very common. It's to see, will you chase him? So if he has been pursuing you, like texting you first and so on, majority of the time, now he might stop texting you to see, will you text him? Will you pursue him? So I would never recommend pursue or text a guy when he does a game purposely to not text you, so you would chase him. Then you will text him, his mind, you will set up a pattern that, okay, then I don't pursue her. And when I pull away, let's say for 2 or 3 or 4 days, that is when she chases me. So in his mind, it will click that whenever he will want you to chase him, he just has to pull away from you for 2, 3, or 4 days. Therefore, I would never recommend for you to text a guy a message first and he didn't text you for 2, 3, or 4 days, because you don't want to reward his bad behavior. Saying this, I think you should for sure text first, sometimes, not when he is playing a game with you. Ladies, when a guy is playing a game of pulling away so you would chase him, a lot of times it is a decision and he does have a set time frame. Usually it's about a couple of days, but in many cases it can take up to a week. And actually a lot of dating coaches for men recommend not to contact women for a week, so she would start to chase you. Personally would wait it out for a man, text me first after, and then I would tell him that it's not working for me, as of course this is absolutely ridiculous. Number 4, why his silence is a decision is when he's ghosting you. This is very common sense, right? When a guy is not interested in you enough to pursue you, but perhaps he wants to kind of keep his door opened, usually he will ghost you. And after a while, he might come back again. Just for that ego stroke to check in, are you still into him? So ghosting is a very interesting thing. Or I would just rephrase ghosting into not being interested enough in a girl, right? And what men do, we usually come back. We usually come back for that ego stroke just to see, are you still into him? Especially if he doesn't have a girlfriend and he has nothing serious happening in his love life, right? So if a guy has ghosted you, it's not always that everything is lost. You know, when a guy ghosts you, a lot of times it's because either you've been behaving low value, just didn't see you as a girlfriend material, or maybe you just didn't connect, you didn't really click, he just was not that into you. Now, if he ghosted you because you were behaving low value, but you felt there was chemistry and you felt like he was attracted to you and you felt like there were a lot of things in common, right? And he still ghosted you because you lost emotional control, you chased and pursued him, you showed him that you're too keen, right? So in this case, when he comes back again, and majority of times guys come back around, so when he will come back around for that ego stroke, do not panic, just change your behavior into a high value behavior. This is when it will have a big possibility to work out. Why? Because if he ghosted you because you were low value and you were losing emotional control, chasing and pursuing him, wearing your heart on a sleeve and so on, you know, but you felt there was chemistry and connection, you had lots of things in common, when he comes back to you, he will still feel chemistry and connection and lots of things in common. He'll keep, and if you'll change your behavior into a high value behavior, the likability that he will actually fall for you is very, very huge. If you would like to know how to go from low value to high value, check out my video right here. Number 5, why his silence is a decision. If you have a boyfriend or perhaps a husband, or perhaps you're dating a guy and you are sharing with him and oversharing every single day, and you're acting very needy all the time with him, like you're calling him all the time, you're texting him all the time, you come across a bit controlling or too emotional, it's very normal that he will go silent on you after some time. Even if he's a needy person himself, simply because he will need a break. Please think about it logically. You know, when you're that type of person who doesn't speak too much, that's me, unless it's my YouTube channel, and you're spending time with that friend who talks a lot, and she not just talks a lot, but she like blabs a lot or talks about literally nothing, and you, let's say, spent 3 days with that friend, right? After a while, you will need your space, you will need your silence, you will need to recharge and breathe. If that girl will message you again, it might even get annoying because you're just gonna be just leave me to it. I need my space. I need to breathe. So this is exactly the same with guys. If you're always needy, if you're always texting, if you're always pursuing, if you're always emotional, if you're always oversharing, he might just need space from you to do nothing, chill and gather his thoughts together. He might just need space from you to breathe. Once he breathes enough and has all that space that he needs, eventually he will miss you and eventually he will come back to you. So if you do recognize yourself as being a little bit of a chatterbox, as being a bit of a radio, and you feel like this could be a case with you, I would just give him all the space that he needs and would try and be much less needy with him the next time. So he doesn't feel like he needs to disappear on me in order to breathe. Because it's just natural personality differences between people. It is purely human nature. If you want to make this type of relationship work, there will have to be a lot of understanding and compromises made. Ladies, these were my 5 reasons why his silence is a decision and how to handle it. Ladies, if you feel like your guy is playing games with you, I have an awesome video which I would recommend you to check it out. And it's called How to Stop Him Playing Games With You. I will put a link right here if you want to get the video, and also drop it in the video description box below. If you like this video, please press like. Let me know in the comments below what did you think. Join my free Facebook group, which is called Greta's High Value Women School. We are in the same boat, learning how to be women of high value and bring out the best in our men. Follow me on my Instagram. My Instagram is called Ladies Relationship Coach. And for one-on-one with me, or one-on-one with a member of my team, or if you would like to join one of my incredible VIPs, you can book us through my website called gretaberishita.com. And if you would like to know how to stay attractive via text, games, men play on women, how to control your emotions, how to get your ex back, how to love yourself, or how to make your hobby into an online business, I have all of these videos for sale on my website, gretaberishita.com. And I will put a link on how to get them in my video description box below and as a pinned comment under this video. Thank you for watching, my queens. Kisses from Dorset. Mwah.